Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for FDOT Connect. I'm Candy Daffin, CAD Support Specialist. Today I will be going through the Automated Quantities Workflow Training Guide. In this series of videos, I will take you step by step through each exercise from the guide. Today, we'll start with Chapter 5 of the guide. Let's begin. The topics we will cover include how to launch and use the Designer Interface Quantities Builder tool, and we'll review the workflow for uploading project quantities to Designer Interface for Ashtaware project pre-construction. Unlike the rest of the training guide, this chapter doesn't have any exercises, since accessing Designer Interface requires a mainframe RACF password. But I'd like to demonstrate the process for those who will need to use this workflow. It's also a good idea to be familiar with the processes, even for those who won't be uploading the files, so that everyone understands the requirements for the files. Once the project quantities have been generated and all Excel summary reports and the estimated quantities report PDF have been created, the next step is to upload the quantities through Designer Interface into Ashtaware project pre-construction. The first step in this process is to download the project header from Designer Interface and save it in the project's lead discipline folder, usually the roadway folder. If you don't already have the link for the WebGate portal web page saved, we have included a link in the Open Roads Modeling Workflow FDOT tab in the Resources Tool Group for FDOT links. The WebGate portal link is at the bottom of the list. On the web page, locate the link for Designer Interface. When you click the link, it will take you to a sign-on page where you will need to enter your username and password to get access to Designer Interface. Even for FDOT users, you must have permissions granted to access the mainframe, and the password will be set up separately and might not match your everyday Windows access password. Once in the Designer Interface page, you'll need to locate your project number. For our demonstration, I'll be using the CAD Office testing project. To download the project header, you can either click on the Export Header link from the Project List page, or if you've clicked the Update link and are within the actual project detail, you can click the Export Header button near the top of the page. Notice that my test project is currently empty with no items uploaded to the interface yet. I'll click back to the project list and then click Export Header from here. When the file downloads, you may see it appear at the bottom of the web page, depending on which browser you're using. If not, you can find the file in your Downloads folder. If you click the pull-down on the file download, you can choose the Show in Folder option to open the Downloads folder directly. Now I want to copy or move the XML file to the lead discipline folder of my project. So I'll right-click and select Copy, then navigate to my Project Roadway folder. The easiest way to get there is to go back to my CAD file and click on the Explore Directory's current workset, and it should open the folder of the file we currently have open. Then I can right-click in the folder and select Paste to complete the copy process for the XML file. Now the XML file is saved to our project, we can proceed with the next step of the process. The next thing we want to do is to open the Designer Interface Quantities Builder tool. There is an icon in the FDOT Connect desktop folder to launch the tool. So on the desktop, locate the FDOT Connect folder, and then we can find the green icon named Designer Interface Quantities Builder and double-click to launch the tool. In the Quantities Builder tool, the first thing we need to do is direct it to the XML file we just copied to our project. So I'll click the Browse button and navigate to my Project Roadway folder. Since I've recently tested this process, it still remembers the last path, so I don't have to search through my folders. But on the first load of the tool, you'll have to navigate the full path, since the tool is opened outside of the FDOT Connect ORD environment. Select the project header XML and click Open. You should get a successful message, and click OK. Check to make sure all your project information shows correctly. Then we need to direct it to our Excel spreadsheets. So, in the Summary Reports Location section, we'll click Browse and navigate to the Project Calculations folder. This time, I'll have to start from scratch and locate my work sets and my project, then click on the Calculations folder and click OK. Now in the Project Summary Reports File section, you'll see a list of all the Excel files in the Calculations folder, except the EQR signature.xlsx. We've set the tool to ignore that file, since we know that Excel file doesn't have any quantities in it. Notice the Group ID column. Each summary report is set with a default group ID which corresponds to the category or group defined in the BOE Chapter 9. We'll take a look at that in a minute. If you click the arrow, a drop-down list will show all the available groups that were delivered with the project header. If a group is not defined in AshTaWare Project Preconstruction, it will not appear in this list. If a particular summary report belongs in a different group than the default setting, you can change it here. For instance, if you had a project with multiple structure numbers, each structure would have a separate group number that could be selected from the list. Next, let's take a look at the output file location. Notice that the output is set to the same folder as the project header location and has the same file name, except it has an underscore and out.xml. This is the output file name and location of the file we will upload to Designer Interface. As with the other quantity tools, there are selection buttons at the bottom, and we can choose Select All. Once we're happy with our settings and selections, we can click Create. But I'm going to hold off on creating the file for a minute while we take a look at the BOE and talk a little bit more about some limitations of the tool. So back in our CAD file, once again, let's click on the FDOT Links tool, and this time select the Basis of Estimates manual. I want to take a quick look at Chapter 9 to show you where those group ID numbers are defined. So in Chapter 9, let's scroll down to the section on headers, and then we can look at this table. Notice the groups on the right of the page and see that some pay item number ranges can be in more than one group. Since we're uploading the quantities by summary table, each summary table will only have one group ID that it belongs to. So unless your project has unique group numbers, as sometimes happens in structures, they should usually fall into the default groups. If you need to check to confirm the right grouping, this is where that information is located. Let's take a minute to talk about one of the current limitations of Designer Interface Quantities Builder. As of the April hotfix of FDOT Connect version 10.08.02.01, the CAD office is still developing an enhancement to the tool that will allow it to process quantities that have lump sum unit along with a secondary unit of measure. Unfortunately, at this time, the following summary tables will cause errors if you include them in the XML to upload to Designer Interface. The summary of clearing, grubbing, and removal items. The summary of special detours. Summary of structure quantities. Summary of temporary highway lighting. And the summary of temporary traffic control plan items. For now, we recommend leaving these files out of the XML and entering any quantities from these summary reports manually in Designer Interface. I'll demonstrate what happens when you include them in the upload in a bit. We expect the enhancement that will allow us to process these files to be delivered in the next maintenance release of FDOT Connect. So back in the Quantities Builder tool, with all of the Excel files selected, including the clearing and grubbing, I want to create two output files. If I try to change the file name in the dialog, it won't let me, so I'll go ahead and click Create. Then we can go to the Roadway folder and change the file name so we know that this first XML includes the clearing and grubbing and will cause problems with the upload. So I'll change the file name instead of underscore out. We'll change that to underscore bad. Then I'll go back to the Quantities Builder and uncheck the clearing and grubbing file. And this time I'll leave the file name with the underscore out name and click Create. Now, in the Roadway folder, I should have two output XML files, and we can go back to the Designer interface and try to upload them. Back in the Designer interface webpage, if the page has timed out or if you logged out before processing your files, you may need to log back in with your mainframe username and password. Once you get to the project list page, locate your project number, and you can click on the import link. You'll need to click Select Files and navigate to your Project Roadway folder. The first file we'll try to upload is the one where we changed the file name to BAD. Remember that this XML included the summary of clearing, grubbing, and removal items. And since that report contains pay items with dual units of measure, we expect to get an error. So select the file and click Open. The file name will appear in the Select Files section. Then you can click Upload File. And here's the error message we expected. Notice the red data validation errors bar and the message that says that the units of measure do not match the master pay item units of measure. There's a blue link with the error code that if you click it, it will open the error code list with an explanation of what the error code means. The blue data validation help link above the red bar also goes to the error code list. Keep in mind that the XML upload in Designer interface is an all or nothing process. If the upload generates an error, nothing from the XML will get imported. Any errors must be resolved and the entire XML must be valid for a successful upload. Since we know what is causing this particular error, we can cancel out of this upload screen, and it takes us back to the project details. From this page, we can try again with the other XML file. Let's click the Import button. Once again, we'll need to click Select Files, and this time we'll select the underscore out XML file and click Open. The file name appears on the upload page, and we can click Upload File. This time we get a green bar at the top that says Data Validation Successful and Project Successfully Loaded. You can scroll down and see all of the pay items in the quantity data that was uploaded. Let's go back to the Project Details page. And now we can see that there were items uploaded to the roadway category. If you click on the item's number, you could continue to add in the pay items and quantities for the clearing and grubbing items or any other pay items that need to be manually entered. When you're done with the upload and entering any extra data into Designer interface, make sure to log out of this screen. Finally, we want to make sure that all the information that we entered into Designer interface matches the information in our Estimated Quantities Report PDF. So we can use the WebGate reporting tools to generate a project edit report, which creates a PDF of all the project quantity data that has been entered into Ashtaware Project Preconstruction through Designer interface. So back on the WebGate menu page, let's click on the Ashtaware Project WebGate reporting login. On the login screen, you'll need to enter your mainframe username and password and click Login. On the reporting page, we're looking for the section that says Designers, Estimators, and Reviewers, so expand that section, and then at the bottom of that group, you'll find the Project Edit Report. When you click on that link, you'll see a list of project numbers. You'll need to scroll down and locate your project number and select it. Once you've selected the project number, it may take a moment or two, but be patient, and then the output options will appear under the pick list box. For this report, we'll want to select the PDF option, so just click on the PDF button and it will process the report. When it's finished, you may see the PDF download appear at the bottom of the browser, or you can find it in the Downloads folder. If you click the down arrow and select Show in Folder, it will open the Downloads folder and then we can open and review the file. In this case, we're seeing some pay item error messages, but that's because we have unused categories on this project that don't have any pay items entered yet. You can scroll through this PDF and check to make sure that all of the uploaded pay items are showing correctly and see if there are any other errors. You can also use this document to check against the Estimated Quantities Report PDF to verify that all the data has been entered correctly and the quantity information in the EQR matches the information in AshtoWare, as is stated in the signature page of the Estimated Quantities Report PDF. I recommend saving a copy of the Project Edit Report in the Project Estimates folder as backup documentation, though at this time it's not a requirement. Language may be added to the FDM to add this step to the quantities process. Once all the quantities are successfully entered in Designer Interface, and the Estimated Quantities Report PDF has been QC'd and verified to match, the Engineer of Record can sign and seal the Estimated Quantities Report PDF and include it on the project submittal as required by the FDM. This is the end of the automated quantities workflow for FDOT Connect for Open Roads Designer. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office series for FDOT Connect. This was Chapter 5 of the Automated Quantities Workflow.